فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل، وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، أما بعد. إن شاء الله تعالى, this is the second part in the explanation of the book كتاب الصفات للإمام الدارقطني رحمه الله. This book, from its name, كتاب الصفات, as we spoke about yesterday, it deals with Allah's characteristics and attributes. And this book, the way it's structured is that the author, he brings narrations and evidences for every characteristics which he states. But what we have to understand is that he doesn't speak about all characteristics. You see, he doesn't speak about all characteristics. He only sufficed himself with some of the characteristics. And the reason why he did that is because لِيُبَيِّنَ النَّهْجَ السَّلِيمِ بِهَا. The reason why he did this is because he just wants to show you the correct way in which Ahlus Sunnati wal Jama'ah deal with Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala's names and attributes, or his characteristics and his attributes. And the qa'idah according to Ahlus Sunnati wal Jama'ah is what? Al-qawlu fi ba'diha qawlun fil kulli. Whatever you say about some of Allah's names, if you affirm some of his names, then you should affirm the others, just like you've affirmed this one. So he doesn't need to do all the characteristics of Allah. If he gives you some, and he shows you that these are characteristics of Allah and that they should be affirmed, مِنْ غَيْرِ تَمْثِيلٍ وَلَا تَعْطِيلٍ وَلَا تَكِيفٍ وَلَا تَشْبِيهٍ. If he does that for you, then, as you would say, the rest is like that. The rest is like that. So he brings these characteristics, he wants you to affirm them without any, as we said before, is what? إِثْبَاتٌ مِنْ غَيْرِ تَمْثِيلٍ بِلَا تَمْثِيلٍ وَتَنْزِيهٌ بِلَا تَعْطِيلٍ. And that you also surrender to the texts, the نصوص الوحيين, the Kitab and the Sunnah. And you surrender to it. And that you do not oppose it with your own intellect and say, oh, how can we affirm these characteristics for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? So any evidences that he provides which is authentic and is sahih, then it's something that a person should affirm. And that is why he did not mention all the characteristics of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, but he mentioned some. The nasikh, the one who wrote this book and brought it together, he says the following. He says, وَصَلَّى بِسْمِ اللَّهِ الرَّحْمَنِ الرَّحِيمِ وَصَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَى سَيِّدِنَا مُحَمَّدٍ وآله وصحبه وسلم. So he starts the book by saying, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, in the name of Allah, the most merciful, the most gracious. وصلالله. We spoke about the word صلالله, that the salah means what? We said that salah means ثناءالله, Allah praising the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam في ملأ الأعلى. And we took the opinion of what? Abu Aliyah al-Rayahi, the statement in which Imam al-Bukhari brought it in his Sahih Mu'allaqan بصيغه الجزم. وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وآله. On our master نبي الله محمد. The prophet is سيد ولد آدم وآدم ولا فخر. He is the children of Adam. He is the master of the children of Adam عليه الصلاة والسلام. وآله. And also may the salah be upon the family of the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم. وصحبه. And his companions. وسلم. And may peace be upon them as well. And then he says, ولا حول ولا قوة. There is no strength. ولا لا حول. There is no ability nor strength. إلا بالله. Except with Allah تبارك وتعالى. قرأت. I recited. Or I read. على الشيخ الإمام الحافظ أبي الحسن علي بن معالي ابن أبي عبد الله الرصافي يوم الخميس أول ربيع الآخر سنة 44 و600. He says, I read on الشيخ الإمام الحافظ أبي الحسن علي بن معالي ابن أبي عبد الله الرصافي. I read on him. يوم الخميس, I read on a Thursday. أول ربيع الآخر. The first of ربيع الآخر. When the year was what? سنة ست سنة أربع وأربعين وستمائة 644. قلت, I said to him, when I was reading on him, the Nasikh is saying, he said, قلت, I said to him, أخبركم الشيخ, you were told and informed by الشيخ أبو محمد عبد الخالق ابن عبد الوهاب ابن صاب ابن الصابوني قراءة عليه وأنت تسمع. You read on him and you were listening. I mean, he read on you. قراءة عليه, reciting on him, وأنت تسمع whilst you are listening. في ذي القعدة من سنة 92 و500. When the year was 592. قال, he said, أخبرنا أبو العز أحمد بن عبيد الله بن كادش قراءة في سفر سنة 19 و500. And he read on him when it was the month Safar, the year 519. And Ibn Qadash here is Ahmed ibn Ubaidillahi Abu al-Izz, Ahmed ibn ibn Qadash. He's mashhur, very well known, and is from Mashaykh ibn Asakir, the author of the Kitab Tariq al-Dimashqa. Ibn Asakir is his teacher. As Hafiz al-Dhahabi mentions in his Kitab Mizan al-I'tidal, أقر بوضع الحديث. He affirmed that he fabricated narrations before. وتاب وأناب. And he repented from it. And he came back. That is, if we accept, if we take the opinion, because the scholars of hadith, they differ upon, can the repentance of the liar ever be taken? In other words, of course, him, between him and Allah is right. But can we ever accept his repentance? If he ever says, I repented, can we accept that repentance from him? The scholars, they differed upon it. They differed upon it because they said he could also be lying about his repentance. His repentance can be a lie. So there is a khilaf. Ala kulli hal, this is the one who we spoke about yesterday, the issue pertaining to it. قال أخبرنا أبو طالب محمد بن علي بن الفتح بن محمد بن الفتح المعروف بالعشاري في ربيع الأول سنة 50 و400. قال أخبرنا الشيخ, and here it is now. So عشاري, he said, I was told by العشاري, هذه كان فقيها حنبليا. He was a faqih, a jurist. He was of the Hanbali madhab. خيرا, a noble individual. عالما زاهدا. That is what his tarjama says in Shudurat al-Dhahab by Ibn Ahmad. And he lived for 85 years. And he was a very tall individual. That is why they called him Ushari. He had a very long, he was very tall. He said, قال, that's why they called him that name, Ushari. قال أخبرنا الشيخ أبو الحسن علي بن عمر ابن أحمد بن مهدي الحافظ الدار قطني قال. So Imam الدار قطني here now, this is where the book starts from. So all of that men were before دار قطني. You see, this is what concerns us now. This is what we'll observe and give importance to in terms of chain. Is what حافظ الدار قطني says from this minute onwards. You see, إثبات القدمين لله تعالى. The chapter here, inshallah ta'ala, is affirming two foot for Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. How are we going to do that? First of all, I'm going to go through this. I'm going to do it with four stages, inshallah ta'ala. Affirming 2 foot for Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. I'm going to do it with four stages, inshallah ta'ala. The first one is al-adilla. I'm going to give you the evidence. And I'm going to bring it from the book itself. The evidence that we affirm for Allah tabarak wa ta'ala qadam. I'm a qadamain. Second thing is, I'm going to also speak about what the Sahaba said pertaining to this particular issue. Regarding this particular issue. That's the second. The third one is the kalam of the ulama of Ahli Sunnah. The fourth, which is the last one, is ibtalu ta'wilat al-mu'attila. Those who've come, who have negated and rejected the characteristics of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, or these particular characteristics, falsifying their interpretation, inshallah ta'ala. So let me start with giving the evidence first. الإمام الدارقطني رحمه الله said حدثنا عبد الله بن محمد بن عبد العزيز إملاء من لفظه. So he dictated it for us from its wording. He said حدثنا عبيد الله بن عمر القواريري. Pay attention. I looked at some of the نسخ. You see the مخطوطة, the manuscript of this Kitab al-Sifat that is in Jami' Islamiyah. What it does is that it misses this part in brackets. You see, al-Shaykh Abdullahi al-Allama, Fadilat al-Shaykh Abdullah ibn Muhammad al-Ghunayman, Hafidhahu Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, Shaykhuna, our teacher, who now resides in Qasim. He done a tahqiq of this particular book. You see, he has a tahqiq on the kitab, Kitab al-Sifat. And mashallah, what he did was, he made sure that he brought the sanad from the play, from some of the, because the, as I said, the sanad that is the copy of the makhtuda in Jami' Islamiyah, there's a saqat min al-asr. From the original, there's a missing narration. And I'll explain a bit about that when I come to it. Al-Shaykh Abdullah ibn Muhammad al-Ghunayman, what he did was, he realized that this is missing. And in his recent copies, he's made sure that he corrected this. Even he got it wrong at the beginning. In his old copies. You see, and also some nusakhs, even till today, they have them. This mistake. Which is that the sanad straight away starts from Harami ibn Umara. So it says straight away, حدثنا حرمي ibn Umara تقال حدثنا شعبة عن قتادة من دعامة السدوسية عن أنس ibn مالك رضي الله تعالى عنه. When in reality, حرمي ibn Umara and دارقطني, between them is بينهما مفاوز تنقطع دونهما أعناق الإبل. There's between them a very long distance. For example, Daraqutni was born, according to the opinion that we took, was what? 300 and what? 306. Some scholars, they said, no, it's 307. So you have 306 or 307. Okay? Harami, he died 201. And Daraqutni was born when? 306. And Harami ibn Umara died 201. How much is between them? 100 years and what? 105 years. 105 years. Then this is a mafawiz. تَنْقَطْعُ دُونَهُمَ أَعْنَاقُ الْإِبِلَ. So the correct sanad is this sanad, which is حدثنا عبد الله بن محمد ابن عبد العزيز إملاء من لفظه حدثنا عبيد الله بن عمر القواريري. هذا هو ده صحيح. حدثنا حرمي بن عبارة قال حدثنا شعبة عن قتادة. شعبة اسمه شعبة بن حجاج أبو البسطام العتكي رحمه الله تعالى. عن قتادة من الدعامة السدوسي عن أنس بن مالك رضي الله تعالى عنه عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. Now you might question yourself and ask yourself this question because we already took it. Qatada is a what? He's a tabi'i. Yeah, but what did he narrate this hadith with? He narrated with an, right? And we took that Qatada is from the mudallisin. He's a mudallis. And he narrated this with what? An'ana. So what do we do with the an'ana of Qatada tamna da'amata al-sudusi? How do we deal with it? The way we deal with the an'ana of Qatada is that, as Bardiji rahimahullah says, أصح الناس رواية. Bardiji rahimahullah, he says, the most authentic person in the narrations of Qatada is Shu'bah. Shu'bah ibn Hajjaj, Abu Bistam al-Ataki. لماذا? Why? كان يوقف قتادة على الحديث. He used to what? He used to stop from the narrations that Qatada then tadlis on. He would authentic, he would ask him, did you drop anyone out? He wouldn't just take it based on his an'ana. Qatada, or he would leave him. Also, Al-Imam At-Tirmidhi in his Ilal, Ibn Rajab explained it. Ibn Rajab Al-Hanbali has an explanation of what? On Al-Ilal At-Tirmidhi. He rather has an explanation of the old Kitab Jami'u At-Tirmidhi, but we didn't find it. It's mafqood. So far, it hasn't been seen. Okay? But only what was found was what? The Ilal. The explanation of the Ilal in Tirmidhi. Ibn Rajab brings in his Ilal. He says this statement. He says, أحاديث شعب عن قتادة عن أنس عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كلها صحة. All of them are authentic. All the narrations of شعب عن قتادة عن أنس are authentic. All of them. And Hafiz ibn Hajar said in Fathul Bari, 11th volume, page 146, لأن شعبة ما كان يحدث عن أحد من المدلسين إلا بما يكون ذلك المدلس قد سمعه من شيخه. Because شعبة's methodology and his way was that he would not narrate from anybody who were from those who done tadlis unless that مدلس had heard that from his شيخ. Bayhaqi in his Kitab al-Ma'rifa, he says that Shu'ba said, Shu'ba said, كفيتكم, I sufficed you from تدليس ثلاثة, three men's تدليس, I sufficed you from it. Meaning I verified it. الأعمش سليمان بن مهران الأعمش عن أبي إسحاق يعني أبي إسحاق السبيعي عن قتادة من دعامة السدوسي. All three of those I have sufficed you from them. In other words, I have verified which one is he narrated with an'ana and he was doing tadlis on and those which he wasn't. Also, in the مقدمة of الجرح والتعديل ابن أبي حاتم الرازي رحمه الله, an authentic chain, it says that شعبة, he used to say, كنت أتفقد فم قتادة. شعبة said, I used to check whatever came out of the mouth of أبو قتادة بن دعامة. شعبة say this. فإذا قال, if he says سمعت أو حدثنا حفظت. If he would say, I heard, حدثنا, or he told us, he said, I would memorize that from him. وَإِذَا قَالَ if he says حَدَّثَ فُلَانِ so and so said, mean if he did تدليس تَرَكْتُهُ I would leave him, he said. So this narration of Qatada's an'ana, there's nothing to worry about. Okay? There's nothing to worry about. Qatada, whose name, what's his name? Qatada ibn Da'amat al-Sadusi Abu al-Khattab. His kunya is عن أنس بن مالك رضي الله تعالى عنه, the noble companion أنس بن مالك غني عن التعريف, no need to say who he is. Very rich. We know him very well. Ani Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, from the Messenger of Allah, yulqa finnari. A group of people are going to be thrown into the hellfire. Yulqa finnari. A group of people are going to be thrown into the hellfire. Wa taqulu. And it will say, who will say this? The nar will say this. Hal min mazidin. Is there any extra that are going to be thrown into hellfire with? Hal min mazid. Is there any ziyada? Is there any additional? The hellfire will say. Hatta yadha'a rijlahu fiha. Until Allah places his leg in there. Oh, qadamahu. Or he places his foot in there. Fataqulu. And it then says, qat, qat. The dhabt of qat is two ways. The Arabs, they say it two ways. There's two ways to say it. You can say qat bi fath al qaf. You can say bi kasr al qaf. You can say qit. That's a wajh. It's a way that the Arabs would say it. And what it means is that hasbi kafani, enough, suffices me. Suffices me what? Ma ulqiya fiya falaysa fiya ma ulqiya fiya falaysa fiya muttasi'. Anything that has been thrown into me, I have no place for it. Whatever has been put in me, I have no place for it. Like, I'm overloaded now. That's what it says. That is what it says. When Allah Ta'ala places his foot inside it, or his leg, then this is the response that it gives. So this hadith is a dalil. It's an evidence that Allah Ta'ala, he has a what? He has a qadab. Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah, they affirm that for him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because the evidence, the issue was what? Al-ithbatu, an-nuthbita lillahi, ma athbatahu linafsihi. That we affirm for Allah that which he affirmed for himself. We also affirm for Allah that which his messenger affirmed for him. And that we also affirm, that we also negate from Allah that which he negated from himself and that which his messenger negated from him. So the qa'idah according to Ahlul Sunnah was what? لا يتجاوز القرآن والسنة. We cannot surpass the Quran nor the Sunnah. When it comes to what? When it comes to Allah's names and attributes and his characteristics. So we have here a clear-cut evidence. We have a clear-cut evidence of Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala's what? Characteristics of Al-Qadam. So we affirm it based on that hadith. And many other evidences are going to come to us, inshallah ta'ala, to expand on that more. Sahaba's ridha, which is the second point now. We gave the evidence. The second evidence is what? The Sahaba's ridwanullahi alayhim ajma'in. What was their mawqif? How were they like? Do you have any athar mawqufa? Statements of the Sahaba's pertaining to this particular characteristics of Allah. And what did they say? Did they say that Allah doesn't have a qadam? Or did they say he does? You see? Rather, we have athar from Ibn Mas'ud and Abdullah ibn Abbas and Abu Musa al-Ash'ari. You see, that they, and all of them are authentic. You see, they're all authentic. That Allah tabarak wa ta'ala has two foot. Two. Qadamayni, they affirmed. And they said it was two. Such as Ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhu. He says, Al-Kursiyu bayna yaday al-Arsh. The Kursi is in front of Allah's Arsh. So what's the kursi? وَهُوَ مَوْضِعُ الْقَدَمَيْنِ. And it is the place where Allah plays, the place for Allah's foot. But he says الْقَدَمَيْنِ, two foot. This, even that though it is مَوْقُوفُ لَفْظًا, it's مَرْفُوعُ حُكْمًا. Even that though it is the statement of Ibn Abbas' statement. You see? But the ruling that it takes is mawquf. Marfu'. It is mawqufu lafdan sahih, but it's marfu'u hukman. In terms of its hukum, it's marfu', meaning it is the sahabi's statement, but it takes the ruling of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The reason why it does is because the characteristics and the attributes of Allah are what, as I said, la yutajawazu al-Qur'an wa sunnah. You cannot surpass the Qur'an nor the Sunnah. So a Sahabi will not affirm a characteristics unless he has evidence from the Qur'an or the Sunnah. So this, as I said, it is موقوف لفظا مرفوع حكما. And it is also from what? It is also from the غيبيات, the unseen. And you can't speak about the unseen based on اجتهاد. لا مجال للاجتهاد. There's no place for اجتهاد in this. So where did this come from? It came from the Prophet صلوات الله وسلام عليه that Ibn Abbas got it from. And this statement of Ibn Abbas is authenticated by Abu al-Hakim al-Naysaburi in his Mustadrak. And he said, وَهُوَ وَصَحَحُ عَلَى شَرْطِ الشَيْخَيْنِ. Pay attention, it's not only that he authenticated it, but he said it's upon the conditions of Bukhari and Muslim. And Dahabi agreed with him on this. And Al-Albani agreed with him in his مختصر العلو لعلي الغفار. He agreed with him on it. And also Bayhaqi brought that statement in Kitab al-Asma'i wa-Sifat. And the muhaqqiq of the Kitab al-Asma'i wa-Sifat, Abdullah ibn Muhammad al-Hashidi, he authenticated it as well. Also Ibn Khuzaymah brings it in his Kitab al-Tawheed. That's the statement of Ibn Abbas. As for the statement of Abu Musa al-Ash'ari, Hafiz ibn Hajar brings it in Fathul Bari, in the Kitab al-Tafsir, the chapter Babu, فَإِنْ خِفْتُمْ فَرِجَالًا أَوْ رُكْبَانًا. And when he brings it, this is the statement that he says after he brings it. He says, وَرَوَى ابْنُ الْمُنْذِرِ بِإِسْنَادٍ صَحِيحٍ عَنْ أَبِي مُوسَى بِمِثْلُهُ. He said, this statement of Ibn Abbas, the likes of it, Ibn al-Mundhir brought a sanad which is sahih from Abi Musa al-Ash'ari, that he said something like the kalam of Ibn Abbas, something like it. Are you with me? So we now have two noble companions of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We have Ibn Abbas, a sanad which is authentically transmitted from him. And we also have Abu Musa al-Ash'ari, radiallahu ta'ala anhu, half brings it unauthenticated. Hafiz ibn Hajar. He goes, وَرَوَى ابْنُ الْمُنْذِرِ بِسْنَادٍ صَحِيحٍ عَنْ أَبِي مُوسَى الْأَشْعَرِي. This is Hafiz is saying this, Ibn Hajar. Very good. Now let's look at the kalam of Imam Ahli Sunnah. The statements of the Imam Ahli Sunnah, what they said regarding these particular characteristics. أَفَامِ صِفَةُ الْقَدَمِ أَوْ الرِّجْلِ. Can we affirm any of these two characteristics for Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala? Al-Imam ibn Khuzaymah, Imam al-A'immah, he's called. They call him Imam al-A'immah. In his Kitab, Kitab al-Tawheed, the second volume, page 202, he chapters a chapter and he says, this is what he says his chapter is.